Yo, welcome, YouTubers! It's your boy Desert Fox coming at you again with another Wargame Red Dragoon Ash and Shadows mod Blitz playthrough. Yes, we are on. What is this? Nuclear Winter is coming, but this time we're doing the same thing in our Blitz category. We're taking some of our best decks and seeing if we can go head to head with the CPU and see if we can't drive him off of his point as fast as possible. I think we just did this with NATO. Literally didn't take any losses. Very surprised. Normally I take like some micro loss or something. But we're gonna try this with PACK. So here we go. Outstanding. There we are. There's the map. There's Fedor, Cheriton, Ivan, and Elena. Ooh. Pretty lady. Pretty point. It's gonna give us a whole lot of juicy command points to destroy the enemy. So what's the plan? It's gonna be kind of the same aspect, right? Cheriton, this part is more of an open, ticky fight, so you need to take your BP boys and their BP toys. Over here is a little bit more, I'd say, infantry-based. You have some gaps in here and, like, here and stuff, but really, it's just an ATGM heaven, as we found out in the last map. So, we'll try to run a little bit of the same. We will take these guys on the wings. We will take these guys on the wings. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, yeah, they'll be right there. And they'll be accompanied by these doohickeys. 1, 2, 3. To support them on the wing. And then we are going to take these guys also for support. Take 3 of those. Nice. We're also going to take, we are doing the Blitzkrieg challenge, so the objective is to get down and take the enemy as fast as possible. What are we going to take here? I do want beefier boys, but I don't want it to cost me an arm and a leg. So we'll take some of those, and then we'll take a platoon of these, like one, and then we'll take 2 platoons of the other ones. Well, we'll take 1 and 1. Yeah, we'll do 2 and 2. Yeah, boom, boom. Cool. So, and actually, I will not do that. This is what we will do. We will take these guys, and we'll take that, but we'll have the support of these guys to go along with them, and the long-range support of these boys and girls. Nice. Right on. And then now, we'll take a couple of these. Ooh, and you know what else we could take? This guy. Go figure, a recon? A hang unit. Like, where do they do that at, right? Clearly in Russia, or PACK. So there's that. We'll have some Terminator just in case we run into some infantry support. And since this is a wide open map, I'm going to take this guy. I really don't take him a lot, but he is a fire and forget, long range, 2800 meters unit. So I'm going to just take like 2 of them, and we'll see if we can use them. I don't know. We'll see what happens. We also will take some air power. I'm really a big fan of these guys. They're only 90 points, and they get in there and they mix it up. So, hats off to him. All right. So the game is starting. There's that. They're going forward. These guys are going to accompany them, and then we're going to get these guys moving. Go out there. Go out here to do some scouting, and then you boys are going to go this way. Accompanied by those guys. Okay, yeah, get going, guys. Okay, we got some groups, and just watch our guys and do their fuck fizzle. Yeah. So they're just trucking along. Here we go. I'm just trying. The objective really is to take out the crazy Ivans out there at Ivan, and we're gonna start calling in a command vehicle for Fedor. You see our aggressive recon here, looking to see how far we can advance. Yay, there's the enemy tank force right there, look at that. They are not, this chopper is not a Comanche, so I can't just run them at everything and turn off all their weapons. I actually have to be a little tactical. Okay, so we will launch a bazooka or whatever attack. We'll get these guys in a formation, and we'll get these guys moving forward to see if we can't give battle to the enemy. It might be a little bit of a tank fight. Actually, we'll take the smaller platoon out that way. Kind of have him just fan out a little bit. So they didn't take the bait down the road, but our units are going to give battle to this one tank. I do believe he is just to keep them at bay so that these guys can get across the road, so good to run onto the computer. But to no avail, we're gonna beat him to the mark here. Beat him in the forest there. I'm kind of amiss on what to do because our units aren't really in the position yet. So we're just gonna arty and hope for the best. These guys are gonna post up in these buildings there. In these buildings there. And kind of set up to ambush the enemy. That's the play. Got some choppers going out that way. And so we're attacking the rear guard of the enemy. We are going to try to maneuver that way. He's got some tanks going out on their own. We'll take that, and we'll raise him a, So as our units are kind of the enemies everywhere, but we are catching him with these ADG units here. Got those guys pincered in there. And we're just going to provide fire on that side. I am worried about our flanks a little bit. So what I'll do is I'll have these guys go wide in case the enemy is doing some tricky stuff. I also probably need to recon that way. But his armored units are the ones that went out there are definitely getting picked up for sure. We have these longs continue to press forward. But the recoiling rifles are doing wonders against the enemy at range, while our ATGM units are kind of picking them off slowly, which is good. He does have Gregory, so in good order, I will probably match that at Boris. I'm not sure if we're taking some damage here. Doesn't look like we have, but. We're covering our guys with some EDG units. So, I need you guys over here. Very nice. So, this is a sticky situation. We're going to lose. Actually, you guys stay right there. The enemy is actually maneuvering here in the forest. So, we saw the tanks a little late, though. But he does have some tanks in the forest. So, that could be bad for us. We're going to arty that spot. And if he, no the tanks. Yeah, we came out. There they are. Boom, boom. And we're going to bring in some air power on it. It's a really close-in fight. So we're going to lose some tanks there. But it is bad for us because we got caught slipping. So we lost a couple tanks because we got caught slipping. But, maybe we can continue to advance without those two tanks. Yeah, we got caught in caught slipping. But we've pretty much advanced to the river, which is good. And we've advanced on this side, which is really good. We need to get our infantry moving. These infantry are a little slower. So, we might have to get them in their actual, doing it. They got a large tank component coming here. So it could be a good idea to keep them in the buildings to see if we can intercept. We're going to have to go out wide, see if we can catch the enemy slipping. Yeah, so the enemy keeps maneuvering down this way, but we'll have the range advantage on him. Oh, there it is. So, ATGM's doing a good job. Advancing, okay, I'd say. We'll tell him to come back and him to go there. But look at the range on these PTZ-89s, man. They're going to make light work of, So each time they shoot a tank, we're just gonna pick them off at range. It's a chopper string out here. Gazelles, you guys are gonna have to pick that guy up. We did lose 400 points so far. Those tanks. But because the enemy has the ability to call in units, it's going to be a dicey fight for us. We kind of need to get our guys moving forward. Look at this. Ooh, that's a coming in vehicle. Take that back. So, Apache, see if he can get that and pick that up. But these guys are rocking the hard place, taking ATG fire from one side and PVZ-89 fire from the other. That's pretty cool. It does look as though we might have an ability to cross the river on this side, so that's what we're going to do as well, all the way down in Ivan. And we've taken out 3,000 points of the enemy and lost 400 points of our own, advancing down, I'd say, 70% of the map, and picking up most of the stuff as we go along. So, dominating performance so far. It isn't like the NATO one where we didn't take any losses. But I mean, this is Russia. What are you gonna do? We don't care about our peeps. Let's load these guys up, and these guys are pretty much out. But we're gonna load them up, and so we're on the flanks of the enemy, and I'm kind of advancing willy-nilly here, just seeing how the enemy gives battle. But it looks as though we're gonna cover the river right there. This was gonna get popped with the range. These PVZ-89s have amazing range. If you notice, their card says 26-25, and that's pretty good. So these fire and forget missiles, as well as the infantry getting caught in a pincer, and we have pretty good recon to get a battle. So you're gonna, ooh, what are you doing there, buddy? Get back. We're gonna have him get into the forest there. There's not too much we can do. We're kind of running out of missiles, so it's important for us to give battle where we can, but we might call in some logistical vehicles here and then get them moving kind of close to the roads would be nice. So we are applying pressure, and we want to go ahead and call in some reinforcements. What in the regards to infantry can we call in? We'll call in some fast-moving block. Very nice. So as we inch forward here, kind of clearing out whatever attacks us, we're going to cross and apply more pressure on the enemy. I see the Tunguska there, but we're going to advance to a point here and get our guys moving. We'll call in some infantry support to support us here, and hopefully they don't have an AA unit lurking in the forest there as we advance. This PTZ-89 will cross and dominate this road here. So we're doing pretty good, I'd say. This, I don't know what's there. It's got a light infantry unit there, and he's got one round. So it's kind of a dicey fight, but he's going to cover these guys, and I'm going to advance on the enemy. And this ground is going to advance forward and covered by these guys right here. So kind of a whole lot of cover and maneuver for our guys. But we still have somewhat some missiles, and we have this Apache here that we really haven't used. And we're going to advance down this way. So, reinforcements coming there. Fob captured here. Very nice. We'll advance out here. And this is a expensive bait unit to see if we can draw any enemy fire. But it is a tank, so we'll see how that goes. He's going to make light work of that guy. Okay. We'll give him fighting orders there. This guy is going to support us as we advance on these Spetsnaz. Spetsnaz are pretty tough, man. Yeah, I'll say it. Spetsnaz are pretty tough, but they're not fighting alone. We're advancing slowly but surely. And we've got these guys in reserve. So we'll go ahead and drop them. And then move our choppers in a more advantageous position. They might not have a whole lot of recoilless rifle left, but they got enough, boys. That's not a fight I really want to hold against this Spetsnaz, but he's going to have to fight all these IMVs as he charges bravely forward. And we see something back there, so what we'll do is our PTZ-89s, they are light, but they're cheap, and so we're going to use those. to get the job done there. And these guys, now that they're gassed up, are going to cross the river and try to hem in the enemy with some light fire support. Heavy fire support. These guys are going to actually drop. And, I mean, we've pretty much conquered the entire map. If I was the enemy, I would have been surrendered. These guys are a good rear guard, so we'll keep them there. And then we'll keep these guys here to dominate the road. Now it's just a matter of finding the enemy and hunting him down. So that's what we'll do. Infantry is advanced to the last spawn point of the enemy, and it seems as though his last man point is there. We'll pop him out very spectacularly, give battle. Maybe they have some, they probably have some AA back there, but it's interesting. He sees my unit. Apache, did you get any kills? No, probably not. But they've got, oh, here's the other command vehicle. So we will also get battle. And look at that, there's a whole buck. And defer. And fire at the buck there. Hopefully he gets him. Yeah, there we go. Get out there, buddy. Yeah, Strayla's gonna get some shots off. He might take him down. Ooh, both of them. Yes. So there's one. And then the other one. Okay, so there it is. So 48. 55, not bad. 12 minutes, pretty good. But 92%, I'll take it. Not as good as the NATO on this map with the perfect, but hey, what can you do? You are not NATO, you are the Reds. So, honorable mentions here, the PTZ 89. Remember, this is a 35-point unit. Popping tanks, T-80s, Tunguskas, you name it, because of that mighty 2650 range on the gun. And it's basically one of the best tank killers in the game. This guy did his thing. PTZ 89 typing out tanks. The infantry, very good for these guys. I don't even know how to say it. Barbitska Prez. Knocking out that CB and a whole bunch of infantry with the recoilless rifles. These are pretty good infantry. These are heavy tanks, but you know, they didn't have to do much because the PTZ 89s, yeah, they're beasting. The lean down, pop a lot of tanks. Fire and forget missiles, guys. If you're not aware, it's basically they can shoot and the missile will do the rest. Everything else is tracked. So fire and forget in the buildings and the forts are pretty effective. And I think these guys hit top attack, so even better. Tapping up two Tunguskas, very nice. Honorable mention to you, buddy. I hate Tunguskas when you're fighting against them, not when they're on your team. These guys as support vehicles did amazing. IV fighters, so you have the infantry forward and support the infantry with these IVs, so not too bad. Same thing here. Ludong, good job. More Ludong, good job. APDZ 89 is very nice. These support vehicles taking out helicopters and infantry, so loving it. More tanks, PTZ 89. I mean, this is ridiculous, dude. Look at that. All that from one unit. Why? Because he has no range. He can just pop it. Most of it's light, but you can't even say, oh, it's just light units. Look, all tanks. Everything is. This is a 52-point unit, and he took out three of them and Tunguskas and Bucks. Love that unit. Great way to trade. The long range missile, the 2800 missile, very good. Pops some units and a buck. So, yeah, and it's fire and forget, by the way. Again, case in point. We took two heavy tank losses. Both of these units are 150 points, and it's sad because we lost 87-point units. Go figure. Again, that's why in a close-in fight, it really doesn't matter the unit type. This is a horrible trade. But we prevail, so it's like, oh my goodness, it's 10%, these two units are 10% of the entire enemy's loss. Well, it says 405, so yeah, it's 300. I don't know where the other 100 points came from, but yeah, ooh yeah. All right, boys and girls, so this is your boy Desert Fox. Thank you for joining me in this Blitz campaign, and hit that like button, that subscribe button, and don't forget to share with your big homies and your little homies. Thank you for joining me. Have a good day and goodbye.